Hi, I'm Dave Cross. In this quick Photoshop tutorial, I want to show you how you can easily turn anything into a brush, including your signature. Now, I've watched lots of tutorials on YouTube where they talk about how to make a watermark or how to make a signature, and frankly, a lot of them make it much more complicated than it needs to be. Really, what it comes down to is you can define a brush in Photoshop out of anything, where anything black is the brush, anything white is see-through. So you don't need to make transparency, you don't need to make a selection, you just need to have that set up. So for example, here I signed a piece of paper with a pen, and I took a photograph of it and I've opened it in Photoshop. And that's all I need to do. As long as the signature is black and the background is white, that's all I need to do. Just go under Edit, choose Define Brush Preset, and then you can name your brush. Now, if you find that you go to the Edit menu and the Define Brush Preset is grayed out, that's because the maximum size you can do is 5,000 pixels. Now, I do recommend making your brush bigger than you think you'll need, because you can always scale the brush down as opposed to having a brush that's too small, and then when you scale it up, it loses quality. So I like to try and make the brush fairly big to begin with. But really, that's all I have to do is just click OK. Now that brush has been added to Photoshop, not just this document, but Photoshop in general. Now, if I want to add this, I simply add a new layer, and I just choose what color I want my brush to be. I'm going to use white. Press B for brush, and usually it will load, if you've just defined the brush, it'll load it there. If not, you can go to the brush picker and it will be one of the last ones you just created. Now that's a little bit too big, so I'm going to use my left bracket key to make it smaller. I always start with 100% opacity, click once, and now it's on there, and then I can use the layer opacity to lower it down if I want. So that's it. It really just comes down to that. Whatever is black is opaque, whatever is white is completely see-through. Now, if you have something with shades of color or shades of gray, then you're going to create a brush which has different levels of opacity in it, which is fine. And you could make a brush out of a photograph of smoke, you could make it out of a multicolor logo, but the key thing to remember is your brush will always just be one single color. Now, the advantage of using a brush is then just becomes a one-click kind of operation, but again, if you have anything that requires more than one color, you can't do it this way. You'd have to use some other method, such as putting something in your library, a topic for another video. But just to show you another example here, I'm going to come over here to this. This is an old document that's been in my family for a long time, which is a deed to some land or something like that. And I want to make that into a brush. Now, if I did it right now, I'd have to look at it this way, is that there's nothing that's completely black and there's nothing that's completely white. So I'd get kind of this weird semi-see-through brush. So I'm going to use an adjustment layer like levels. I'm going to take the black eyedropper and say I want this to be black. Then I'm going to take the white eyedropper and click on this background and say I'd like it to be white. Now, it's still not going to be perfectly black and white, but we're going to get a little closer. And ultimately, it's okay if it has some odd shading, because normally what I use a brush like this for is an overlay on top of a photograph where I'm going to play around with blend modes and things like that. So now I can once again go back to Define Brush Preset. There's my new brush been created. Now let's go here and I'll hide this other one I was playing with. I'm going to make a new layer once again, take my brush tool. And in this case, the brush is so big you can't even see it. I'm going to use the left bracket key and start to scale it down. You can see now I have a smaller brush. And again, I have white as my foreground color. I'm going to click once. It puts that, which looks kind of a little over the top, but that's okay, because once again, I would play around with things like opacity and maybe blend mode like lighten, and double click and tie a blend if slider. Again, a topic for another day. But there, that gives you an idea of creating a brush. And again, don't forget, it's really very simple. If you have something open in Photoshop, as long as it's less than 5,000 pixels in its biggest size, then you can make it into a brush. You may choose to play around with blacks and whites beforehand, but it's a really interesting creative possibility to take anything from a signature that you've created to a logo to something like this, where it's just a little more artistic. Really interesting way to do things in Photoshop. As always, be on the lookout for my next quick little Photoshop tutorial, and I'll see you next time.